In this video, we're continuing on with the Multi-Step Pythagorean Theorem Problems Worksheet, picking up with number 7. We're calculating the area, rounding our answer to the nearest tenth. So for area, we need base, and we need to know the height. We're given the height is 10. However, we don't know what the base is because we need to calculate this other side length. Let's call it x for now. And the way we'll calculate x is by using the Pythagorean Theorem. If this side was also 12, it'd be really easy to calculate this because we would know that this intersects at the midpoint. Although we're not given that this third side of that triangle is 12, therefore this does not equal 8. So we need to calculate. So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So I'll do x squared plus our height, 10 squared, equal to that hypotenuse of 12 squared. X squared plus 100 equals 144. Subtracting 100 from both sides, I'll get that x squared equals 44. And when I take the square root of x squared, x will equal the square root of 44, which is 6.63, which rounds to 6.6. So if x is 6.6, I can now calculate my base, because my base is 8 plus 6.6. And 8 plus 6.6 will give me 14.6. So area equals 1/2 of that base, which we calculated to be 14.6, times the height, which is given as 10. So 1/2 of 14.6 times 10 equals 73. So the area in number 7 is 73. In number 8, they give us the height again, which is 5. So we need to calculate the base, and they give us a portion of this base as 8, but we need to know this length so that we can add them together. So our base is our unknown, but our height is 5. So let's call this length within this right triangle y. So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Y squared, the leg, plus the other leg squared, 5 squared, will equal that hypotenuse squared, 7 squared. So y squared plus 25 will equal 49. Subtracting 25 from both sides, I'll get y squared equal to 24. And when I take the square root of both sides, y will equal 4.89, which rounds to 4.9. So if y is 4.9, my base is 4.9 plus that other length, 8. And 4.9 plus 8 is 12.9. So my area, A, equals 1/2 of 12.9, the base, times the height of 5. 1/2 of 12.9 times 5 equals 32.25, which rounds to 32.3. So 32.3 is the area of the triangle in number 8. In number 9, again, we're not given our base, so we have to find a portion of that base in order to add to get the total base. So let's call that portion x. Our height, however, is given to us as 3. So I know that x squared, one leg of this small triangle, plus 3 squared will equal 7 squared, our hypotenuse. So x squared plus 3 squared is 9 equals 7 squared, which is 49. When I subtract 9 from both sides, I'll get that x squared is equal to 40. Then I'll take the square root to get that x is equal to the square root of 40, which is 6.32, which rounds to 6.3. So if x is 6.3, I can now calculate the base. 6.3 plus 4 will give me my total base, which is 10.3. Now, time for area. Area equals 1/2 of that base, which is 10.3, times the height of 3. 1/2 times 10.3 times 3 equals 15.45, which rounds to 15.5. And that's rounding to the nearest tenth. So 15.5 is my solution in number 9. In number 10, we need to calculate the height, and we also need to calculate the base. So we need to figure out what this distance is. However, since this side of the triangle is congruent to this side of the triangle, I know that this is an angle bisector. So this will bisect at the midpoint. So if this side length is 6.4, then this side length is also 6.4. So our base is equal to 6.4 plus 6.4. And that is 12.8. So now all we need to do is calculate the height. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. So let's call this height variable h. So a squared plus h squared will equal c squared. So 6.4 squared plus h squared will equal our hypotenuse of 9 squared. 6.4 squared is 40.96, which rounds to 41. And that's 41.0, which we can write as 41. Adding that to h squared will equal 9 squared of 81. Subtracting 41 from both sides, I'll get that h squared is equal to 40. And taking the square root of 40, our height h equals 6.3. So now that I have the base and the height, I can calculate area. Area is 1/2 our base, which is 12.8, times the height, which is 6.3. So 1/2 times 12.8 times 6.3 equals 40.32, which rounds to 40.3. So 40 3/10 is the solution for our area and number 10. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 11. We're not given the height or the other length of this base. So we're going to have to calculate first for the height, then use that height to solve for this portion, let's call this x, in order to calculate the base. So base, currently we have as x plus 11. And our height is h. So using the triangle on the right, 11 squared plus h squared will equal 26 squared. So 121 plus h squared equals 26 squared, which is 676. Subtracting 121, I'll get that h squared is equal to 555. And the square root of 555, I'll get that our height h is 23.55, which rounds to 23.6. So our height is 23.6. Now let's use that to solve for x. Knowing that our height is 23.6, x squared plus b squared equals c squared. So x squared plus 23.6 squared equals 29 squared. So x squared plus 23.6 squared, which is 556.96, which rounds to 557.0, or 557, that's going to be equal to 29 squared, which is 841. Subtracting 557, I'll get that x squared is equal to 284. And taking the square root of 284, x is equal to 16.85, which rounds to 16.9. So plugging 16.9 in for x, 16.9 plus 11 equals 27.9. Now area is equal to 1/2 the base, which is 16.9 plus 11, which we got as 27.9, times the height of 23.6. 1/2 times 27.9 times 23.6 equals 329.22, which rounds to 329.2. So 329.2 is our solution in number 11. Join me in the next video where I'll complete this worksheet finishing numbers 12 through 16. Also, if you have any questions, leave a comment below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.